What's the best two-factor app? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. Many websites, now including Social Security, are asking users to employ an authentication app for two-factor authentication. What are the best free authentication apps that are usable across both Apple and Windows platforms? So I used to have a very simple go-to answer for this, and I'll mention it before I'm done. But what's best for you is going to depend on what platforms you use, what mobile devices you have, and whether or not you're already using a password manager. So what we're talking about here, what I'm assuming that you're being asked for, is what's called a time-based one-time passcode, TOTP. We often refer to these as Google Authenticator compatible codes because they were one of the first to come up with a robust app that actually provided these codes as necessary. When you set up your account with two-factor authentication, it establishes a cryptographic relationship between the account and your authenticator. What that allows them to do is your authenticator will then display a 6-digit code that will change every 30 seconds. Only that authenticator app knows what the next code is going to be. It's the only one that can generate the code. And they are completely random looking in sequence. The service, on the other hand, is able to confirm that the code it's been given is the correct code for the current 30 seconds. So by being able to provide this Google Authenticator compatible code, you have proven you are in possession of the authenticator that creates it. That then is your second factor. So since we talk a lot about it being Google Authenticator compatible, one of the obvious answers is to use Google Authenticator. And I've got it open here in the Android Play Store. You'll find it also in the Apple Store. It's an app that installs on your mobile device. Google Authenticator is a great mobile-only solution to get you your two-factor codes. If that's all you need, you're actually in good shape using Google Authenticator. However, it's not enough for people like me. What I do is something a little bit different. Again, Google Authenticator and many of the other alternatives are mobile only. But I want it on my desktop. I want it on my phone. I want it on my Mac. I want it on my PC. I want it, well, someday I guess I'll want it on my iPad. You get the idea. I'm on all the platforms, almost all of them. So a mobile-only solution doesn't work for me. What turns out to be happening right now is that many password vaults are adding support for two-factor authentication. In my case, I've been using 1Password. 1Password allows you to set it up as your two-factor authentication authenticator. So, for example, here's my Microsoft account as stored in 1Password. And yes, it's got a username and a password, which I'm not going to show you, but it has a one-time password field here. And you can see there's a little countdown. That number will change unpredictably to you and me every 30 seconds. Entering the current number when I sign into my Microsoft account proves that I am in possession of my second factor. It's kind of interesting because 1Password will often automatically fill in not just my username and password, but if it then sees a subsequent two-factor request, it may very well enter this code for me automatically so that I don't even have to think about it. However, if it doesn't, well, you can see just clicking on it will copy it to the clipboard, and that way you can then paste it into the field requesting the code. Now, the reason I went to this as my solution is because, like I said, I want this everywhere I am. My password vault was already there. Adding two-factor to my password vault basically just makes it easy for me and does not reduce my security by any seriously significant amount. Yes, there are those who feel that doing this is a bad idea. I tend to disagree. But nonetheless, I think that the answer for many people, and it's not just one password, it may very well be the password vault you're using already. See if they are supporting two-factor authentication natively and consider using that as your solution. What if you don't have a mobile device? What if you don't want to use 1Password? The desktop-only solution, there are several, and I'll talk about those in a minute. The one that I'm going to point you to is actually KeePass, of all things. KeePass is another password manager. It uses a different model. It doesn't keep an online database. But it includes support for one-time passwords. So you don't have to use the password management part of KeePass. You can set it up to only take care of two-factor codes. And that's fine. That's a fine approach to doing a desktop-only two-factor authentication app. Now, I will say that every time I make recommendations like this, they're almost always controversial to somebody. I'm almost always faced with a slew of, what about this? Or why didn't you talk about that? It's so obvious. It's not obvious. But if you go out to alternative2.net, it lists 39 alternatives for Google Authenticator. If what I've just described to you doesn't appeal to you, by all means, have a look out there. I've certainly not tried them all. Some of them I've never heard of before. So that's why in a lot of cases, it just doesn't make sense for me to mention them here. However, one thing I am going to recommend, check the comments on this video and on the companion article over on askleo.com. That's going to be askleo.com/172922. I get a lot of really good suggestions from readers for situations like this. I won't say that I agree with them. I certainly can't necessarily endorse them, but they do bring a lot of alternative perspectives to what is an important security answer. Now, if you've been watching me or reading me for any amount of time, you'll probably notice that I'm not mentioning a specific tool that I used to mention all the time, and that was Authy. Authy was my go-to recommendation for exactly this. It was everywhere. It was in Windows, on Mac, it was on my phone. Unfortunately, Authy is now a mobile device-only solution. They have stopped support for Windows and Mac. That frustrated the heck out of me because it was such a good solution across all the platforms. But if they're going to be smartphone only, then sure, they're a fine alternative for smartphone only. I really don't see a strong reason to recommend them over Google Authenticator, unless, of course, you're in the camp that fundamentally distrusts Google. So, bottom line, use two-factor authentication. Regardless of what solution you choose to use, two-factor authentication is a significant security boost for your accounts. Then, if you're open to it, consider using your password vault to be your authenticator. It's an app you should already have, it should already be everywhere you need it, and it's one less app to install. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, and like I said, lots of reader suggestions, visit askleo.com/172922. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.